Hello, Mr. Graham.
Evening.
It's going to be nasty out tomorrow.
Yes, it is.
I don't mind, but I'm afraid my wife doesn't like it.
What are you doing out there? You will catch cold. Come back to bed.
You better go back to bed yourself, Sherry. You're more delicate than I. Have you got a wife, sir?
Yes, I have. Excuse me.
Has your wife got a bad temper, Mr. Graham?
No, very good.
Oh, you're lucky. For years, I lived in misery. Then one day, I made a great discovery. There was a socialist meeting, and I went to it. I wasn't a socialist, understand. I went to this meeting because I was curious. The speaker was good. And a week later, we were out with some friends, and I repeated what I heard. My wife laughed in a very peculiar way. And when I got home, I made a discovery. I found out my wife was a snob, and even more stupid than I dreamed. She said that I humiliated her by saying such things as if I believed them, that all her friends were respectable people, and I mustn't speak as if I was a working man. She wept. Then I knew that I was free. Mr. Graham, I bought books and pamphlets to make my arguments more damaging. My wife became very docile. She even cooked things I liked, just so as I wouldn't disgrace her.
I see. So, you don't believe these things you say?
Oh, that's where my little joke comes in. Mr. Graham, for a while I was free. Then a terrible thing happened. I found I began to believe these things that I said. The books I read showed me that I found a truth. I, a capitalist by instinct, became a socialist by conviction. Worse than that, there was a strike at the factory, and I, the manager, supported the strikers. I didn't belong to a union, naturally, and so I was dismissed. It was ridiculous. So, here I am. I've become a man in my home, at the price of becoming a bore outside.